Hi, I'm Laura Rogers. I work at Rackspace Hosting, and I currently am a manager of SharePoint consultants. And my sort of my SharePoint expertise is that I'm not a developer, so I have figured out over the years all of the sort of ways and tricks to get around do custom business solutions in SharePoint without using code. So I do a lot of workflows, a lot of forms, and some BI, and just kind of make the most of it without before you get to the point where you have to start programming.
So that's how you gained your visibility in the SharePoint community, right? The no-code
yes.
solutions.
Right, exactly. Back in SharePoint 2007, I started using the DataView web part a whole lot at work, and I worked at a healthcare company. And I started getting frustrated at the lack of documentation and books and online and in training classes having to do with the DataView web part. I was just shocked that it just pretty much didn't exist. So I went ahead and just started figuring things out, and I thought maybe other people might be trying to figure the same things out too. And put a few videos together and some just different posts on your in-user SharePoint site, and turned out lots of other people did use the DataView web part and found those helpful.
So. It's been consistent. Everybody that I've talked to said they actually stumbled into the community. There's no planned way that we first started getting into it.
Sounds like my career in general, yeah.
But the videos are interesting. You've gotten over 500,000 views on your videos. So that's a nice content piece. And that's another thing that people are consistently saying, is that if you want to become part of the community, you have to provide some kind of value. And a lot of people are using content as that value.
Right. For me, I'm not good at just sitting here and spouting fluff and just chatting about kind of, I don't know, like there's some people that are really good at talking about non-technical concepts. Like they could just stand up for an hour and talk about user adoption or governance or things, or just concepts like that. And for me, I am more comfortable figuring out like a specific, solution using the technology and explaining that solution and, you know, click by click and how to actually do that. And that's kind of my, my sweet spot and where, I'm most comfortable. And there are even some conferences out there that they pretty much just want to get you to get up there and talk about just businessy type of topics and not necessarily do a demo or do anything technical. And I can't do that. I'm just going to figure out how to do something in SharePoint and share with people how to do it. And that's what I do.
Being a manager,
I do that with my team, and I mentor them and help them figure things out. So that I really enjoy being able to sort of spread my knowledge that way too.
I mean, you've carved out a really nice niche for yourself. It got you on the speaking circuit, right?
Oh, right. So again, I used to work at a healthcare company, and you know, when you work at big corporations, you don't necessarily get to go to all the conferences. You don't. Maybe they'll send you to one every year. Maybe usually every 2 or 3 years you get to go to one. But I went to my first conference was now. First of all, how did I get into the speaking circuit? I had taken SharePoint administrator training in Minneapolis, and Bill English happened to be our instructor, and that was back in 2005, at the end of 2005, and I was a server admin. And he, at some point during the class, he said, hey, you know, there's this new version of the product coming out, SharePoint 2007. If anybody's interested in writing a chapter for my book, just let me know, send me a resume and stuff like that. So I was like, huh. Hung out with a couple of speakers and presenters at a previous conference I went to. Those guys didn't seem like that much smarter than me. I could probably figure this out. So I went ahead and told him I wanted to do that. And, you know, that's how I got to write the chapter in the Moss Administrator's Companion. Wrote it back in 2006. So I knew Bill already. So I knew Bill English, which is very helpful. He's like sort of what the grandfather of SharePoint is, right? What some people called him. So that's how I got the gig at the second best practices conference in San Diego. So that's how I got my foot in the door and got to speak at that one conference. But I enjoyed it so much and had such a great time and really enjoyed getting to meet all the other speakers and that type of thing that I wanted to do it some more. And I knew that my company was not going to pay for me to go to all these conferences. So that was kind of my incentive, is that I wanted to be – I got the speaking gig because right. I knew that once you get a speaking gig, then the conference usually pays for you to get there and then I didn't have to worry about whether my company would pay for it or not.
But why would you want to go to conferences? And that's not a rhetorical question. What is the value of going to these conferences?
Well, for me, in SharePoint, there are a lot of just kind of things that I was figuring out on my own and just experiences that I had within users and experiences I had with the technology that, you know, you're kind of sitting there out in your day job and you're struggling through all these things and you feel like you're alone sometimes. And when you get to go to a conference, you get to meet all these other people that are going through the same thing you're going through. And then you're learning a lot of great tips and tricks in the sessions and you're chatting with, you know, the speakers and you're kind of picking their brains about other things. And it just makes you feel more comfortable in your job when you get back to work, is that other people are all experiencing the same type of thing you are. And you find out that there are, you know, ways to solve problems and you know, better ways to get around in the technology or just ideas that you didn't have before. And I love also just the personalities hanging yeah. out with, you know, my now good friends, all the other SharePoint speakers.
It's interesting that for me, I find the most value in the hallways between the sessions.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
At the last SharePoint conference, I think I went to maybe two sessions the entire week. Yeah. I knew that they were going to be online later, and I spent most of my time in the expo hall and right. just hanging out with, yeah, my friends.
The interesting part for me outside of SharePoint is I think that what we're talking about actually translates across industries. We're talking SharePoint because that's the way you and I met, but in general, I'm finding like I'm going to security conferences now. I'm going to AppSec and OWASP conferences. And it is the same thing that when you get there, it's the people that you've seen online are there. You get to develop real relationships as far as that goes. I know that we have...
Are they all in those other technologies? Are they all up in the social media and Twitter like we are? Because I think SharePoint pretty much beats them all with that stuff.
I don't know. When you get the DevOps and the AppSec, there's a lot there. And that's what I'm dealing with now. Okay. But it is a good point, yeah, that you make. The other thing that I wanted to cover, too, is the value of community. I get a kickback all the time on, is there a real value, a sales value? If I'm a salesman, why in the hell would I want to do all this stuff? I want to go out and sell product. Is, in your mind, honestly, is community part of the sales effort or not?
Yes. And, okay, so I worked at about 3 or almost 4 years ago, I worked at SharePoint 911. And SharePoint 911, the whole company, all 16 of us got bought by Rackspace Hosting, which is a giant company, which is the world's largest hosting provider, and it's got like 5,000 employees. So that was part of the value of buying us, is that most of us are out in the community and kind of famous in the SharePoint community and have a lot of traction on our blogs and things like that. And but they have just recently sort of made a statement that they said that our Microsoft Technologies group within Rackspace is the most open group. And when they're saying like open, they're not necessarily meaning open source, like Microsoft's products aren't open source, but we're open in that we share what we do with the community as a whole. And we are out there and we're speaking at conferences and we're blogging, and the company does see that as a value. We drive hits to the website, we drive traffic, we drive sort of brand recognition. When people go to conferences, they see the Rackspace booth and they see, they might recognize us from our blogs, but then when they come to see us, they're like, oh, you work at a company called Rackspace. What is that? You know, so that's kind of that we do. We're fortunate that we work for a company that does recognize that and does see that social media is important and that we are personally valuable to the company.